coming from the center of the universe and the Thrive15.com world headquarters.
Let's go!
Presenting the world's only business school without the BS, with optometrist and entrepreneur Dr. Robert Zoellner and the former Small Business Administration Entrepreneur of the Year in your ear, Clay Clark. It's the Thrive Time Show on Talk Radio 1170. 3, 2, 1.
Bang, boom. It's hump day. That's right, Thrivers. It's Wednesday. My name is Clay Clark, your co-host with the Mo-Ost. I'm the former SBA Entrepreneur of the Year in your ear. And today I am talking to you about a subject that is very near to my heart. It is the six principles for successful public speaking. You see, I used to travel around the planet talking about business, how to grow a business. Just Google my name tonight. Google Clay Clark Reviews or Clay Clark Speaker. And there you will see I've spoken for Maytag and Hewlett-Packard and O'Reilly's and Chevron. My mother's bunco parties. That's a lie. I've never spoken for my mother, her bunco parties. She doesn't have bunco parties. I have really never spoken for any event that my mom attended other than my brother's wedding, which I sort of spoke, but I was a disc jockey, which is kind of a low. It's like if you're a disc jockey, it's one level below a carny. So it's kind of a carny is a carnival worker who heckles people. One level below that is a DJ. That's what I was. And so that was real talk. But today I'm joined here with really incredible people who've known me from college and till now. So it's they're like truth cannons. They're like, hey, listen here, homie, you weren't that good. You weren't very good. I tell you what. But we have Miss Sharita Bent, the co-hostess with the most S. Miss Sharita, how are you?
Did my wedding and you did a great job. Do you remember?
I remember your you wedding. It was epic. Yeah. It was epic.
At the Scottish.
Jamaican.
Yes, we had our
at the Scottish Rite.
That's where our reception was. Yeah.
And I remember the song Just Like Glue.
Yes, Sean Paul
was introduced to me.
Yeah.
And I went, whoa. Yeah. This is something I can work with here. It was really good. The whole deal.
It made an impact on Clay. Yeah. I mean, that was it was a great, great reception.
Oh, fun. Man. I learned about Kevin Little.
Yes.
I learned about Bob Marley, that whole Jamaican squad. It was great. And I'm also joined here with my wife of 15 years who just could. The thing is, my partner, Dr. Zoellner, he's an optometrist, okay? And he is not here today. He's expanding his vast empire. But he has never been able to help her vision, so she hasn't actually ever seen me, which is how I stay married.
Perfect vision.
Yeah,
she does. Yeah, but it's Miss Vanessa Clark. How are you, bird?
Doing great, thanks.
All right, so we're talking today about the six principles for successful public speaking. Now, is today's show for you? Maybe you got a lot going on. I mean, you could go over to 106.9, our sister station. You could be listening to some Bieber and some Taylor Swift and some One Republic, or you could be listening to this show. So you got to be really sold on the why do I need to hear this show? So do you ever have to make speeches or presentations at work? I mean, have you ever had that happen? Have you ever been asked to speak and you're like, I'm here to talk about something. You know, have you ever done that? Have you ever felt sick? Like just sick, unable to, because you have a speech tomorrow and the whole night you're like, how are you? How are you, John? I'm doing good. I'm excited about my talk. And you're just like you're going to vomit because you're just dry heaving. I'm good. I'm good. I'm going to do this speech. I'm going to nail it. You're feeling nervous. Have you ever seen somebody speak and just mangle a presentation? Have you ever wanted to become somebody who's a good speaker? If that's you, this show is for you. We're talking about speaking, and Sharita, I'm gonna ask you this. I'm gonna ask you this from your perspective. This is just totally off script. There's no statistics. I just want to ask you.
Yeah.
From your perspective, why do most people perceive people that can speak well? They always say you're so well spoken. Why does the average person perceive someone who speaks well as being an authority? Why does that happen? Why do people go, wow, you're on a pedestal of awesome because you're a good speaker? Why is that, you think?
Well, I think it may have something to do with a confidence and, you know, that energy comes across. And maybe if you're fearful or you have that nervousness about it, you may look at that quality and say, oh my gosh, like, look at that. That's so admirable.
Vanessa, what is your take on this?
I just think the ability to communicate effectively, if you don't have it, your point is never even getting across. So there, if you can communicate effectively, you're very intentional about the message you're sending and that you know what message people are receiving. It's very intentional.
Now, check it out. I want you guys to Google this tonight. I want you to Google this. Check it out, because I want you to research it. Don't believe what I'm saying. Use the law of credibility, which states that I should never say anything that's not true. The law of credibility is you should never say anything that's not true. And then you build credibility by being truthful, which is rare. So the thing is, I want you to go ahead and Google a guy by the name of Daniel Goleman. G-O-L-E-M-A-N. He's a best-selling author. He wrote a book called Emotional Intelligence. And what he discovered is, no matter how good you are at welding, no matter how good you are at making those kicks, no matter how good you are at producing those videos, no matter how good you are at making those houses, at the end of the day, the person who's in charge is a good communicator. They have high emotional intelligence. And the peak of emotional intelligence is to be able to get up there in front of a group of people that you do not know and to communicate effectively. So let's think about who was the most successful, Shrita, for 500 points in your mind, who's the most successful computer guy in the history of the planet? Computer guys.
Oh, I'm going to go with Steve Jobs.
Let's go with the most successful media female, Vanessa, media female.
Oprah,
my favorite.
Oprah?
Oprah, I love you.
Why didn't you guys say Barbara Walters?
She's second place to Oprah.
Yeah, she's probably eighth place.
Yeah, probably eighth or ninth.
Yeah. Okay. I love Oprah.
I feel like Barbara Walters is forgotten. I love Barbara too. So who is the most successful? I don't care if you're a Republican or a Democrat. Who is the best speaker in the presidential world in the last 10 years? Who is it? Let's go with
10 years. I was going to go before that. So.
I'm going to say the last 10 years. If he says the last decade.
Obama.
Yeah.
President Obama?
Definitely. I was trying to think. Yeah, definitely.
Shameless Homer alert, whether you're a Democrat or a Republican.
He can give a speech.
He's good. And so because he can give a speech, he can touch your heart. Uh-oh. And when someone can touch your heart, now they can get you to start. Now we have this thing called people who are motivated, so you have to learn persuasion. Okay?
Can I say something about this too? I want to encourage listeners, because they may be thinking, oh no, I never have to make speeches or presentations. Like, none of these things apply to me, but you never know when you may get called upon to. So,
and also, a speech doesn't have to be something in front of 50 or 100 people. It could be you're standing in front of a group of 5 people, and it might be a group that you're managing, but you're
so
elevating yourself to a new standard when you can communicate your idea or what you want done to those 5 people and they receive what you're saying.
Yeah. Now, here's the thing. Before we start to pontificate and teach these moves, I want to make sure you Google one more thing, because I'm giving you these facts. And again, the law of credibility, I build credibility with you by you verifying that what I'm saying is true instead of being my opinion. Because my opinion is just a random thought that I have. It's not
verified.
Everyone's got an opinion. But check it out. Warren Buffett, Google Warren Buffett and Dale Carnegie. Warren Buffett, Dale Carnegie. And what you'll see is that Warren Buffett said the one most impactful training of his life, the number one most impactful training of his life, was attending Dale Carnegie's public speaking classes. He said being able to communicate is what changed his life. Now, Shrita, we have a mystic statistic before we get into the first principle. Can you read the mystic statistic?
Yes, I can.
Here we go. We're getting ready.
Yeah, it says, no, what really strikes fear in the hearts of many Americans are snakes.
Snakes? That's true. I'm so scared of snakes.
This is true for Clay.
Yes. A recent Gallup poll that asked adults what they were afraid of reveals that more people, 51%, fear snakes than any other suggested possibility.
That's me.
Including speaking in front of an audience, which was 40%, and heights, which was 36%.
Ooh, another one for Clay.
I hate heights. If there was a snake
so
on a
many
tall
good
building,
stories.
I would
it's
just
over.
I'd whack
it's
myself.
Over. It's over.
I would just shoot myself.
It's over. And while children are reputed to fear the dark, only 5% of surveyed adults do. Just 11% of adults fear thunder and lightning.
Check it out. I'm going to interrupt you real quick. This is from Gallup. The reason why I'm reading this is because there's this stupid tale that's been told. You see, if you say things enough, they become true in people's minds, but not for me, no, because I distrust everyone. Yeah. But there's a little statistic that goes, more people fear public speaking than death. Really?
Lies.
Freaking, no way. No way. I mean, death is pretty permanent. I'm not like, I just would rather die than to speak. I would rather just, you might say that, but really, people are afraid of snakes.
Yeah.
But then after that, in the middle of the list, is speaking. Mm. Okay, you got snakes, heights, then speaking. So speaking bothers about a fifth of you.
Yeah, I don't.
But you're
like
not
the
more
snakes.
Worried about it than death. I mean, it's kind of stupid. But the principle. But people say that crap. See, public speakers make stuff up. I'm going to get into that in a little bit here. But principle number one: predetermined in your mind what success looks like. predetermined yes. in your mind. So I'm going to play an audio clip. Here we go. Getting ready. Now, this is clip number one. This is a guy that I heavily endorse. Real quick, Homer alert. I love this guy. If I could, adopt a man who is older than me to be my brother or son, I would. If I adopt a man who's older than me to be my son, it would be T.D. Jakes. This guy is just, I love this guy. He is awesome. Let me play a little audio. Here we go.
Things like low-income housing, HUD income, where clusters of poor people live together. It sociologically, it has not proven to work well. The idea at first was to make sure that people had a place to stay. That's a good thing. But if all the people who stay around you don't have any more than you, it is proven that the kids don't do as well in school.
Oh, see, the thing is, he's talking slow. Mm-hmm. He marinates. Mm. So I love T.D. Jakes because he marinates. To me, that is the peak of speaking.
You always say pros go slow.
Yep. The pros yep. go slow mm-hmm. and the go fast. That's all I'm saying. And the go fast. I'm not going to say that because it's a family show. We shouldn't say what rhymes with fast. But here's another example. Someone says, this guy's awesome. I love this guy. I love him. Here we go.
Who's done this more than once? Say I. When you failed, why did you fail?
Breathing on the mic.
Why are you suddenly tongue-tied?
Why are you suddenly tongue-tied? I'm Tony Robbins.
But here's the thing is, some of you, like, you look at Tony Robbins and go, if I had a
deep voice and I could talk like that and I could breathe on the microphone, I could be Tony Robbins. Hot coals, hot coals, hot coals, everybody, hot coals. And some of you
are wanting T.D. Jakes. You're saying T.D. Jakes is the idea, but you want to start predetermine in your mind what success looks like because you have to get an idea of where we're headed to become a successful speaker.
Live, local, now. You're listening to the Thrive Time Show on Talk Radio 1170.
What's going on, T-Town? It's going down on this incredible hump day. It is Wednesday on the Thrive Time Show during your drive time home. You could be driving home listening to something else, but you have chosen to enrich yourself. And today we're talking about the six principles for successful public speaking. And some of you go, what makes you qualified to teach us? Google my name, Clay Clark, and reviews. Google my name, Clay Clark, Hewlett Packard, Clay Clark, Maytag, Clay Clark, a jerk. I'm sure he'll find something.
He's pretty awesome, I must say. I know you may think I'm biased as his wife, but he's freaking awesome as a public speaker.
I've done well, but the thing is now I don't travel anymore. You have to come to Tulsa. If you want to hear me speak, you got to come to the Dojo of Mojo at the Thrive15 Studios. But here's the deal. We're going to teach you these six principles for effective public speaking. But principle number one, you must predetermine in your mind what success looks like. Now, I'm going to give you some examples. Now, if someone's listening right now, and you're going to go, every time that you say that, it offends me, but I'm going to be real. I go to a church right now. I used to go to Higher Dimensions Church. I went to Higher Dimensions Church because
best church ever.
Carlton Pearson, he used to sing this song, and it was a song, Father Along Will Know All About It. Father along with, and I just would love him singing. I would just sit there and go, mm-hmm. He's touching my soul. Mm-hmm. And it was just so good. Then when he kind of switched, Carlton went from, you know, super Christian to like, I don't believe, I was more of a universalist. I was like, I don't know what I believe anymore. So I had to switch churches. I went to a different church. Carlton's a great guy, good guy, but we switched, you know.
Changed everything up on us.
So now I'm going to a church where this is how the praise and worship sounds. I mean, this is kind of like, here we go. So it's like,
she bends and she sways to whatever song plays without a care in the world.
And inner dialogue, I'm going, this has to be Homer.
He couldn't take it. He physically could not take it. I can attest to this.
I feel like it's a whisper. Jesus.
Here we go. It's been a long day. Everybody sing it with Venus. If you listen to KXOJ every day, it's Stephen Curtis Chapman.
But now you get up and say, I will meet you after.
And you've got kind of messed up hair, and you've got sandals on, and you play your guitar. Here we go.
Have to whisper too. You always got to whisper.
Oh, please. Cinderella.
Jesus.
That's how you do it. You wear sandals. You got tight pants, really tight pants.
Skinny jeans.
Skinny jeans mm-hmm. where you go, I don't think I should see all of my pastor's body like that. It's just hair's mess. And your shirt, you're very casual. That's typically, that's